ATPCO is excited to introduce a new customer support tool. You may use it to report an issue, ask a question, and to request services. You will then be able to watch the status of your submissions via timely notifications in an online portal. At the same time, we are launching password management functions that will allow you to change and reset passwords on your own. The new tool will replace ATPCO's Service Manager application. You can access it by clicking the support links on the Fair Manager homepage and ATPCO's online customer center. The support tool should be your primary method for requesting support from ATPCO. It eliminates the need for you to remember various department mailbox names in order to send a message to ATPCO. The portal will route messages to the appropriate team member for you. While rich in capabilities, the tool is very simple to use. When you open it, you will see announcements, including news about service interruptions, and then options to report an issue, ask a question, and to submit a request. You will also see important information, such as the status of previously submitted requests, and the tool will give you quick access to ATPCO's online customer center and our Fair Manager suite of applications. Let's quickly walk through some common scenarios. First, to report an issue such as system performance or a pricing problem, I will click this link and then will be asked to complete a simple form. Some of the fields are optional. Those that are required are marked with a red asterisk. Some information, such as my name, is pre-filled. Other information will be easy to complete by the use of predictive text. I can also attach files to my submission. Once all of the fields are complete, I will click the Submit button, and then I will immediately receive a confirmation message along with a tracking number. I can return to my request by clicking My Tickets from any page. This list of open submissions, which we call tickets, is organized so that I can see my open tickets and then all of my company's open tickets. I can sort the list, export it to PDF, Excel, and CSV formats, and I can click any one to open a detailed view. You will also be able to return to the details of a ticket by clicking links that are embedded in email notifications. You will also receive an email message when your requests are completed. Within the messages, you will find options to confirm that your needs have been successfully met, or alternatively, options to reopen the ticket for further work. When details are viewed, I can also type messages to ATPCO, which will become part of the ticket's record. I can also attach files even after the ticket has been created. The process is similar for asking a question or submitting a request. For example, if I want to ask a question, I will click this link and again fill out the required fields. You will have a list of topics which will help to expedite your request to the right team for faster service. You can find topics by typing, which will open predictive text options, or you can simply use the drop-down menu. If you do not find a topic that matches your need, you can choose a related topic. ATPCO service representatives will reroute the request to the best department. The comments that you type in the description fields will be read in their entirety. These details will also help to make sure your request reaches the right service team as quickly as possible. Once I click Submit, I will receive a confirmation where I will also have the ability to add comments or attach files. Remember, your comments and attachments will immediately become part of the ticket. You will notice that there are different options for submitting a request. Service requests can be used for general purposes, such as asking ATPCO to release a batch or code a rule. Access and authority requests will open forms that authorized users may submit for services, such as a user ID request. Using the top menu, you can return to the main page or go to other ATPCO options. If you are using a shared computer, you can also click the logout option under your profile name to close your support session. ATPCO is also introducing new options for self-service password resets. The option for changing a password works just like it did in the past, but the user interface has been improved. You will be asked to enter your user identification, your current password, your new password, and then your new password again as a confirmation before clicking Submit. The option for Forgot Password opens a page on which you will be asked to enter your user identification and then agree to terms of service by selecting a checkbox. You will then be challenged to prove that you are not a robot by completing a simple CAPTCHA quiz. You will then click the Submit button and will receive a success message, and then an email will be sent to you with a temporary password and instructions on how to complete the process. For more information, please write to contact@atpco.net.